So Roam Research is a new tool I've been using that I'm really liking. They call it a note-taking tool for networked thought. And what that means is as you're taking notes, you can put things in these double brackets, kind of like you see in Wikipedia, and it links to that new page. It creates a page as you type and links to that page, but also links back from that page. And I'll show you the beauty of that in just a minute. But for me, I used to throw a lot of things in Evernote. What I loved about Evernote is I could just throw stuff in it without having to think about where to organize it. I sort of had some categories and stuff, really could just throw stuff in. And I've since moved to Notion. And Notion is great. I'm completely out of Evernote. Notion is great. The problem is things need to be organized almost too well. So for a lot of stuff, that's excellent. You know, I'm keeping track of project leads at work and events and stuff. The very tight boxes that stuff needs to go in. But I struggled with how just to throw ideas and thoughts in there. I sort of tried different databases and it kind of worked and really never did the job. Roam, I think, is the solution to what I was looking for. So at its core, Roam has these daily notes. It automatically creates a blank page every day and you can just kind of say what's going on. Everyone uses them differently, but an example here is I read this amazing Roam article by Nat, and I linked to the article there. It really is a great article. If you see that, natellison.com/blog/Roam, great article there. But if I were to click on his name or click on Roam, I'd see everything else I ever tagged with that. So I moved more Kindle highlights over to Roam. I went to a meetup hosted by Eddie and Liz. There's notes inside of here then of content research ideas and notes from the meetup. And I sort of took notes throughout the meetup, highlighted some things, linked to some things. It was great. I got a lot out of that, and this is a great place to put it. Another data studio. You kind of see, I just kind of put notes in here about just random stuff. Could good, bad, whatever, link it. The idea is you throw stuff in. If you link properly, and I wouldn't say there's a proper way to do it. If you link frequently, you'll start to see connections grow over time. You can kind of almost find useful rabbit holes. So like if I were to click on Kindle to see what else I've tagged with Kindle, I didn't actually add any notes to this page, but it pulls in all the other places where I mentioned Kindle. So you kind of see it's really basically just a bunch of notes from other things. So we're going to say, oh, this is marketing, a book from Seth Godin. Let's go to that page. So here's a page all about this is marketing. So I call it a book by Seth Godin. If I wanted to, I could click and see everything else from Seth. There's nothing else in here yet. I'm sure as I add more notes and stuff, there will. But in here, again, I've kind of worked through my notes. These are all highlights I pulled out of Kindle. So I went to the Kindle site, pasted them in, dropped them in here. You see all the notes in here. I've highlighted some things back out that link to other things. So Theodore Levitt's, you know, famous quote, people don't want to buy a quarter inch drill bit. They want a quarter inch hole. And I've seen it said further that they don't really want a quarter inch hole. They want a bookshelf to hang. And ultimately it goes back to buying a drill bit, but gets into marketing stuff there. It's kind of cool. But in theory, I can click on Theodore and see everything else I heard from him. And yeah, you can see actually in positioning for professionals, he's in there as well with that same kind of quote. But back in this is marketing, we have this stuff. So another good example, I got a 3D printer for Christmas. We'll just jump into that, 3D printing. So again, on this page, I made a few notes. I found Yagi to be a good resource. I guess to back up, I've never had a 3D printer before, and it's really just a toy for me, printing fun things and useful things, whatever, mostly just messing around. So I'm trying to find resources on how to do this. So I've put a lot of little notes in here over time. I found this flippy desk count, this cool looking high storage system, did more 3D printing. Okay, so I have a page about the 3D printer. This one little issue in Roam is right now you can't have, I don't know how you'd word it, like synonyms for pages. Like 3D printer and 3D printing are two separate pages. And I really like it to be, if I tag either one, take them to one page. It's really the same thing. For now, it's separate. I think they'll probably change that in the future. But I guess alias is the word I was looking for. But still can be kind of useful there. You can link things around there. So I can click like on Ender 3 to see more about this. So this is the brand of the printer I got. So Cura is some software you can use to help make 3D models. You get one format of file you'll find when you download, but you need a different file to print, and Cura can help do that. But then there's different profiles for Cura, and it got really messy. So, hey, so I researched it and found that. So if I click on Cura, again, I can see I love Frank's profile I found here. I found this thread on Reddit. And so here's this whole thread. I can go, and that'll run me off to Reddit to read all about the Cura 3 settings that makes things print pretty well. So cool. You know, I can kind of just keep working my way through. And in theory, because things link together, stuff will surface again more often. And so I've tried really just on the daily notes. Anytime you want, you can click over there. So I took notes from church this morning, kind of, you know, I link through and have a bunch of stuff in there. But you can collapse it down. Just throughout the day, I'll add other notes as I come across interesting articles or ideas or thoughts. And as you go through, you'll see just lots of different things. I installed the Honey Chrome extension I've heard about forever. We'll see if it's any good. I linked up Honey, but right now it's just, there's nothing there. But again, over time, this should become more and more useful. And one little annoyance, I guess, is every time I click Daily Note, it takes me back to today, which I guess is good. But if I'm trying to scroll through and see things, it's a little trickier. But again, looking at cars I might want to buy, the Wi-Fi password at church, things I could add Anki. You know, I use Anki for some spaced repetition stuff. So I have just a page here. Maybe I add like recent presidents and vice presidents going back, or other government folks I should know, or, you know, just other ideas of things I might want to add there. So just making notes of whatever I have throughout the day. And it works really well. And to get an idea of how visually it works, you know, again, in Evernote, things are in, you know, a handful of buckets based on categories. You maybe have tags tying things around, but tags can get a little too general. They can do this graph overview in here to see. And so here's the notes after really just a couple weeks. You can see all my notes. Now, there's some main ones that link up, but really everything just links to everything else. And so over time, this should become pretty valuable. The beautiful thing right now, too, if you go to RomeResearch.com and sign up, as of the making of this video, it's still completely free. It'll be a paid program fairly soon. It sounds like it's with some pretty heavy discounts for educational, nonprofit, you know, that sort of thing. But it's a great program. I'm loving just being able to go in here, just dump my thoughts in here. I still use Notion a lot. I still plan to for quite a while for a lot of structured data, especially around the business. But for just dumping thoughts and ideas and links and notes and stuff, this really makes a lot of sense to me because I don't need to think about it that much. It should work well. So give it a try. Leave a comment. If you have tried it, let me know your thoughts. And